Resident Evil, Shinji Mikami has done it again. In a genre where Michael Bay-esque moments have plagued the experience in place of traditional horror in recent years, the evil within strays away from the norm and brings the survival back in horror. The evil within has all the bells and whistles of Mikami's last foray into the genre, the unforgettable Resident Evil 4, but builds on that foundation with a rise in tension, disturbing sound design, and a horrifying atmosphere. This time around, Mikami and his new development studio, Tango Gameworks, have crafted a more bleak, yet unrelenting game.
Let's expose everything.
One 84 copy, code 3, ETA 3 minutes.
The story begins with Detective Sebastian Castellanos and his partners arriving at Beacon Mental Hospital in the fictional Crimson City. They witness bodies mangled all over the place in a disconcerting fashion. And then, their dementia ensues. The pacing is almost pitch perfect. The discovery of figuring out what is really going on compels you to move forward. But as the story progresses, it starts to lose its focus and comes off convoluted in execution.
What the hell?
Not helping with the narrative is main protagonist Castellanos. His demeanor is preposterous at best. It can be challenging to care about the stakes throughout the 15-hour journey when he shows little to no signs of being affected by his surroundings or characters. Some dialogue is cringeworthy and not in a good way.
I'm a police officer. Maybe I should help you.
Should help you?
Shit. How am I gonna get you to a hospital?
Hospital. 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 Hospital!
What the f***?
After facing countless enemies that would drive anyone clinically insane, he'll ask himself questions like,
what is going on here?
He will begin to put the pieces of the puzzle together well after you do. His emotional detachment to all his findings can be jarring at times. For a detective, he's pretty clueless.
What was that sound?
Gameplay is tight and satisfying. Pulling off effective headshots is as satisfying as ever, especially when you're surrounded. To start, Detective Castellanos' aim is lousy, but by collecting green gel, the game's resource for upgrading your weapons, stock, agony bullets, and overall attributes are hidden in plain sight. The game gives you the option to choose what upgrades you deem worthy to match your playstyle. Whether you prefer to increase your stamina to run away when the battle gets too heated, or if you prefer to go in guns a-blazing to take out every walking corpse in sight. A common gripe of survival horror games as of late is that they give the player too much ammunition. In The Evil Within, however, you'll be scavenging every nook and cranny for ammo, as if it were precious gold. Conserving your ammunition is a must, or else you'll be greeted to a horrific death. Guns you'll find are your typical handgun, shotgun, and sniper rifle variants, but the most distinct weapon at your disposal is the Agony crossbow. You can dispatch your enemies in a variety of different ways. You can stun, harpoon, burn, explode, electrocute, poison, or even freeze your enemies at your discretion. You can also use grenades to quickly eradicate foes, all of which gives you the tactical advantage when taking multiple enemies out on screen. Another tactic you'll need to take into account is burning a seemingly dead corpse on the ground to ensure it doesn't come back to life when you least expect it. This mechanic also allows you to take out multiple enemies without wasting any precious ammunition. When ammo is scarce, you can use items in your environment, such as bottles, axes, torches, or even traps intended to take you out against the opposition. You can disarm tripwire alarms to avoid detection, landmines to provide custom parts for your agony bolts. Melee is the least effective way of taking out enemies and should be avoided at all costs. Being stealthy can vastly increase your odds of survival. When discovered, you can hide in a number of different locations, including lockers, closets, and under beds to rethink your strategy. The enemy AI is unpredictable in its approach to take you out. Every chapter, you will come across different types of abnormal creatures that become more freakish and bizarre looking. Most of the game's boss encounters may seem unfair with their one-hit kill animations, but they are actually reasonably feasible when you plan your hits accordingly. In spite of frequent framerate drops and occasional texture pop-ins, The Evil Within has been beautifully crafted. The linear level design lends to the claustrophobic atmosphere at every turn. The environments in this game that you explore will stick with you well after you finish the campaign, thanks to attention to detail and aid of excellent lighting. The sound design plays a pivotal role in making the player feel uneasy when they start to hear enemies grunting or even breathing in their vicinity. You'll find yourself surveying every corner for any immediate threats lurking in the shadows. This is easily one of the strongest aspects of the game. Through my playthrough, I found the letterbox presentation purposely hinders your sight. When the tension builds, the game will catch you off guard with well-placed traps that you may not see while your eyes are glued to incoming threats. Frustrating at first, you'll subconsciously become more aware to check every inch of the available real estate on screen.
Sebastian?
Despite the game's shortcomings, The Evil Within delivers the survival horror experience that will quench the thirst of gamers looking for a brutal, frightening yet rewarding return to the beloved genre. Those worried that this game is filled with over-the-top action sequences and heavy emphasis on ammunition drops do not need to tread carefully when picking up this gem. Superb gameplay mechanics, stellar sound design, and a daunting atmosphere set a new standard for years to come. The Evil Within gets an 8.5 out of 10.
Am I going crazy? Huh?
Now, what makes you say that?
Oh, God, fucking up!